Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Drops. I'm Sri Priya. So today I'm going to tell about how do you get scholarships or how do you take a scholarships when you wanted to get into the USA universities. So before watching this details, please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to click bell icon for upcoming notification regarding all the USA videos or the USA topics. So scholarships to study in the USA, how do you get this? Friends, most of the candidates who score the highest educational marks or the from starting of your graduation or from your schoolings, if you're scoring the highest marks, the concerned teachers or the concerned principals of according to your schoolings, for example, let us take an example. So for example, if you're completing your 5th standard to 10th standard with the highest aggregation, for 100%, you're scoring a 99 or the 95 ever percentage. So the school or the institute will take care of you by providing a scholarship so that with that scholarship, you will be easily getting into other education levels. So in a similar way, if you wanted to get into the USA universities, there will be some scholarships if you wanted to apply for a USA. Right? Mostly scholarships will not only be according to your education qualifications that are offered by your institutes. If you are getting a highest score, whatever the payment you pay into that university and you are scoring the highest university and making your best performance, the whatever the money that you have paid will be returned back in the form of scholarships. So this type of scholarships also will be. Now let us see all these details. So firstly, what documents do you require to apply for the scholarship in your universities? Academic records and photocopies, a recent CV. CV is a cover, your cover letter. So you have to make sure, CV is in the other format of resume also, but mostly it consists of one or two pages. It's a simpler format rather than the resume. And you have to submit your records of photocopies. So if you're completing your 10th standard education, make sure that you'll submit your 10th class certificates. And even if you're completing your BSc, starting from your 10th intermediate followed by BSc, submit your BSc certificates. So whatever the educational qualifications that you have pursued, you have to submit all those certificates followed by even the CV, like for what you wanted to apply in that particular universities, mentioning in that CV. Then a letter of intent which acts as a cover page. Cover page, friends, don't worry regarding the CV and cover page and resumes, because I have made some resume. Like some videos with the resume separately, CV separately, as well as a cover page separately. So you can watch all these videos in our channel itself. Now, certificate of language proficiency. So as I said, there are language tests also in the previous video. So if you're passing a highest aggregation in any of this that in any of the examinations that you have appeared, make sure even though if you don't get good marks in that particular examination also, you have to submit the certificates that whatever you have taken. So it's mandatory. Then letters of reference. Letter of reference is nothing but, so if you have any persons that are known to you from that university, or the persons, like if you wanted to go for university, make sure that you will write a letter of reference from your lecturers or the professors where you have pursued recently. So it's, as I said in the previous video, it's very mandatory. With them, you will be easily getting into this university for your higher educations. Now let us see the criteria. So eligibility criteria. So now let us see firstly eligibility criteria for a student. So for the students, you should be an Indian national. So whatever the country you belongs to, you have to make sure or submit your proofs that you are belonging to that particular country only. And then followed by, you must have a strong academic record. You should have a perfect academic record. For example, if you're having a educational aggregation from 80% to 90%, 90% to 100%, it's very better that you will easily get into the university for education. Then you must be seeking an admission to a professional, technical or another course of studies. So if you wanted to get into other courses, or if you are taking a training regarding those courses, you have to submit all those documents also. Like from so and so month to, or from so and so date to so and so date, I am taking a training, so for getting into your university or for writing the examinations, you have to mention all those details also. Then you must have secured admission test for the foreign university institutions. Like for every university, not only in India, even the foreign universities also will have an entrance examinations. If you have written those entrance examinations followed by your international examinations, you have to submit that particular university certificate also when you're submitting your document. Then you must be above the age 18 years. So as I said, it's mandatory that you should have age above 18. And else your parents can be available to the loan. If not, if you're below the 18 and you're going along with your parents, then it's mandatory that your parents should submit your documents for your education with their documents in for universities that they wanted or you wanted to apply. Now, eligibility of course. Which type of courses? For what courses you can get into the USA universities? So firstly, for the graduation, job-oriented professional or the technical courses offered by the reputed universities. If it is for the graduation or that is nothing but an undergraduate graduation, you have to submit the job professional or the technical. So whatever the profession you wanted or the whatever the courses that you wanted in the undergraduation, you have to submit that particular. That is nothing but your statement of purpose. Then for post-graduation, you should have a qualification regarding the, for example, if you have pursued the undergraduation, if you wanted to make a post-graduation, you have to submit whatever the documents that you wanted. If it is for the master's in your CA or the master's in the business management or the business administration or the MS is nothing but master of sciences, you have to submit that particular course details. Also diplomas. So the courses could be from the foreign universities, institutes approved by the state and central government. So according to their state and central governments, your certificates will be approved. Now coming to the loan amount. So it's not easy to get into the foreign for not only the single person from your from low standards to higher standards. For every person, it's mandatory that you have to take a loan to get into the foreign countries from the India. So if your total fees is around the 10 lakhs rupees, the bank may offer to give you a loan of 80%. And of the amount, and you will have to put in the balance of 20%. So you should pay 80%, your bank will be offering to get into the loan along with your documents that you submit for the bank purpose, and 20% of the balance you should definitely pay for the bank. That is a mandatory. Then the maximum loan amount offered by the public sector banks for the studying abroad is generally around 20 lakhs. So from the public sector, whereas for the other not the normal or the common banks that you have applied, other banks will provide up to 20 lakhs for your education as a loan, and you have to clear those 20 lakhs in according to your perspectives or the bank perspectives or according to their rules. So if the bank charges you 1% as a processing fee, that will be an additional cost you will have to cover. So if it's offering anything which is less than or the more the higher percent, whatever, it's mandatory that you will submit according to their perspectives. Now documentation required. So what type of documents you have to submit? So you will have to provide the acceptance letter sent by the university. So when friends you are applying for an application form, you filled all the details you have submitted within the time or within the deadline, you have to wait for their letter that they accepted your letter. If you are getting that acceptance letter from their university, then start getting into your loans and other formats of the step-by-step process for applying your student visa and everything. Without their acceptance letter, don't try to put into this. But of course, there are some universities, they check with these loans, documents and everything only, they will give you an acceptance letter. So whatever the purpose it could be, you have to have an acceptance letter from your university. Then you will also need to show the mark sheet of the last qualifying examination. Before getting into your university, whatever the exam that you have to, even it could be a 1 year back or 2 years back, you have to submit that last examination scorecard for them. Now repayment. How will be the repayment or for the scholarship? That is nothing but whatever the payment you have paid, and if you scored the highest score or achieved the best in that college or the university, you will get your money refunded in the form of your scholarship. Now, repayment starts only after the course period. So when you start your course, when you get into that course, after your acceptance letters, you will join into the university. And then you'll be entering into the course or the midst of your course. Then your repayment will be starting. And if the students got employed with 1 year after completion of the course. So as soon as you complete your course and as soon as you complete your course, you are getting the job. So with that job also, your repayment will be depending. And the loan is generally to be repaid in the 5 to 7 years. It's not much as you think. Faster you complete, faster you'll get your repayment. It's not like that. It depends upon their own perspectives and their own situations. It can be refundable by 5 to 7 years. Now, friends, generally you will get up to a maximum number of 10 years to repay your loan. So this will be not only for according to the scholarships they provide. If you're getting in, if you're taking a loan from your Indian banks also to get into that universities, everything will have a tenure of payment. So by that tenure of payment only you can submit your loans. If you're achieving the scholarships, make sure you'll submit with your scholarship and pay your or clear your bank loans or helping your parents. So it depends according to each and every time or the situations. So friends, these are all the procedures that you have to take care of when you are applying for university and if you are applying for a scholarship in the universities of not only US or the foreign countries. So I hope you all got the details right. So friends, this is all about today's video. So if you like this video, please raise your thumbs up, share with your friends. And as I said, please comment in our comment section whatever you want. I will try my level best to give all the videos that you wanted. Thank you for watching.